Okay, in this video, I'd like to show you some sort of fun extremes in apparent motion. So what we discussed sort of in the last videos are that this apparent motion here is primarily due to the Earth's rotation. And that's sort of what makes the stars move for us. But what's also an important part about apparent motion is actually your own location on Earth. Like, in other words, where are you when you are up looking at the sky? We saw a case like this in an earlier video where we were doing looking at the height of Polaris, and we did all this business with how you have to bend your neck to see it, if you recall. And in that case there, if you were at the North Pole, you'd have to bend your neck at 90 degrees to see Polaris, where if you were at the equator, you would just have to look straight ahead and not bend your neck at all to see it. And so that had to do, again, moving between the North Pole, and the equator certainly had a big effect on where you saw Polaris. So let's look at that now in terms of the more, and just instead of looking at one star, let's look at it in terms of apparent motion of like the entire sky. And so in order to do this, I'm going to use the simulator in just a second here to place us in three different scenarios here. The first scenario is where the Earth sort of looks like this. We won't worry about the tilt for a moment here. And we're just going to say that you're a person who's standing actually on the North Pole. So maybe you're up doing some expedition, you're on the North Pole, and we're all going to remember that the Earth continues to rotate like that. Okay, we'll look at that. In the second case here, we're going to say, okay, here's the Earth again, ignoring the tilt. We don't always need to draw that. And say you're standing on the equator. Probably much easier to get to. You can do some tropical vacation to go get yourself on the equator. And we're going to also remember, you know, the Earth continues to rotate. And in the third case here, we'll look at, we'll put us a little bit closer to home, particularly if we sort of live in North America here. We'll say, okay, we're not going to be at the extremes, the North Pole or the equator. We'll just be somewhere in between like this. And again, we're going to remember that the Earth is rotating like that. And so the question then is, like, what would the sky sort of look like? What would the sky's motion look like? Again, with the goal sort of this video here, which is this extreme motion here. What would the sky look like? And what we're remembering here is that, of course, we're moving around, but there's all these stars behind us that we could be looking at. Same with here, there's going to be stars, and same with, there's always the stars are always up there, there's always going to be, have this background of the star field here. So we just want to see what would we see of the sky's motion, okay? So without further ado, off we go. So here I am in the simulator here, and I'm looking to the west. Now what I can do in the simulator is I can pull this menu up here, and I can move us on purpose to the North Pole. So I know the North Pole is 90 degrees, so I'm going to punch in a 90 right here, and you can see it zapped me all the way up to the North Pole. You can barely see the little arrow tip, little red dot at the top. And now what I'll do is, here we are, we're at the North Pole. Let me go ahead and speed up time, and let's look at what the stars look like. Look at that. Isn't that the most bizarre thing there? You're looking at the stars are just moving sideways, entirely sideways. They're never rising and they're never setting. They're moving exactly left to right. And it's just the most bizarre thing. So if you go back then to our iPad right here, you can see the sky's motion, that up here, when you're at the North Pole like this, you're looking at these star trails that are just going like this. They're going straight across the sky like that. And hopefully it makes sense to you. There's no magic here behind this. It's just pure geometry. That if you're sort of on top of the Earth like this, you're sort of spinning around your own legs, I guess, because you're standing right on the North Pole like that. And when you spin like this with your eyes open, you'll just see stars just sweeping by and sweeping by and sweeping by, straight horizontal like that. Isn't that something? Okay. Now what we'll do, let's go down to the equator. So here we are back into the solar system simulator. And what I can do is grab the location here, and I'll go back to 0 degrees, which is the equator. So it zaps me down to the equator, and you can see the arrow right there, and you can already see something strange happening. Look what's happened to the stars. They go straight down into the ground, not even at an angle. literally perpendicular to the ground. Mars and all the stars that we're used to are just going straight down into the ground, much different than the look at the North Pole. Straight down like that, just the most bizarre thing. It'd be interesting to see this someday. See, there's Mercury and Uranus, and the Sun would just go straight down into the ground like that. It's a little bit harder to see why that would happen here. It'd be much more useful maybe to look at an actual model or something like that. But here we go. We go back to our sort of written view here. In this second case I just showed you, we're now sort of here. This is where we are. And what you're looking at now is, instead of being at the very top of the world and doing a really quick rotation around like that because you're standing on the North Pole, you're now sort of being slung all the way around the Earth on the equator like that. And if you did this, well, I'll just sort of state the obvious that you saw here. You would just see as sort of this section of the ground here, which is the horizon, as that sort of moved with you as you looked, you would just allow stars to be covered and uncovered as they rose. And sort of you would just sort of see like a star like this one right here that might be behind there just start rising straight up like that to the sky. And when it came back down again, it would just go straight back down into the Earth. It's definitely harder to see, but you'd have to sort of just think very carefully about the visuals here. You're spinning around like that, and you're just doing these wide swaths of motion here. And if you want to think about it, you're sort of always in this plane of the equator like that, and it just causes the stars to make these very straight lines going straight in and straight out of the ground, as you can see sort of here as those white lines overlap with the star trails that I've tried to draw. This is not a very good explanation, I acknowledge that, but I think it's the best I can do at the moment without a good model in front of you. So what I'll do lastly, let's go into case three over here, and let's go to a more sort of, find my document again here. Let's sort of go back to a more moderate latitude that we're probably used to here. So I can go back to the simulator here and pull up the location bar again. And a good mid-latitude is about 35 degrees or so north. So I'll go back to 35 degrees like that. Here we go. So you can see it's put the arrow right about the latitude of Los Angeles or something like that, a big city. And now what you see is sort of a happy medium between the two. You're no longer going straight in or straight across, but you're sort of setting towards the west in more of a diagonal motion like that. So anyway, those are some extreme cases of the apparent motion of the sky as you move yourself around. So we see all the three sort of medium in here of the star trails. We get three different cases, not medium, something like this, this, and this. So there you go. Some never set when you're at the North Pole, straight in and out of the ground when you're at the equator, and sort of a more diagonal rise and set when you are at a more mid-latitude. And here's just a quick wrap-up of what we saw. So if you're at the North Pole, North Acute Polar Bear, you would see the stars going straight across the sky like this. They would never rise or set. Either you see them if you don't. And then, of course, if you go to the equator and note the cute palm tree, nice and tropical down there, you would see the stars setting and rising at 90 degrees with respect to the ground like that. Very unusual motion. And then lastly, in the more digestible case, if you go sort of like maybe to 35 degrees or so, a place where most of us probably live, you see sort of a combination of straight across and straight down, which is sort of midway in between. Goes something like this. And note, of course, the cute, I guess, if you will, no polar bear or palm tree, but they just have a tree and some grass, indicating maybe something more urban in terms of a landscape.